So in this example, we are going to simplify tan angle over secant angle using quotient identities and reciprocal identities. Now, it's important to remember anytime you start manipulating an equation or simplifying it, you've got to remember the original function's non-permissible values, or NPVs. In order to find these non-permissible values, we are going to have to apply our identities to a few of these to figure out what those NPVs are. But recognize we are not going to manipulate. Okay, we won't move anything around. We're simply just going to substitute in and solve. So does tan angle, does that have any non-permissible values? Okay, well, here we are going to think about tan angle in terms of sine and cos. So tan angle, this is a quotient identity, sine over cos angle. Now, here we can see there is a non-permissible value. The non-permissible value is when cos angle equals zero. In this case, it cannot equal zero. That's the whole problem. Now, at this point, we should be pretty used to our unit circle. Okay, we should know by this point, cos angle and sine angle can be represented as x and y on our unit circle. So where is the x coordinate zero? Well, the x coordinate is going to be zero at the y intercepts of our unit circle. So this is zero, negative one. This is zero and positive one. Okay, so cos is going to equal zero at these two points. Now, what are these points? Well, this is pi over two, and this is three pi over two. But recognize we can go around and around and around and equal there. So we're gonna have to give a general solution to this. If you notice, this occurs, if we start at pi over two, we occur every half rotation, so every pi. So for our non-permissible value of tan angle, what we can say is x cannot equal pi over 2 plus every interval of pi where n is an integer. So remember, integers, those are like negative 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, dot, dot, dot. And I guess over here, I'll make a few more, negative 2, negative 3, and so on. As long as it's a integer, whether it's negative or positive, and 0. Okay, so now we found the non-permissible value for tan. What about secant? So secant, we're going to use a quotient, a reciprocal identity. So if we focus on our secant identity, secant angle equals 1 over cos angle. Well, guess what? This is actually going to have the exact same non-permissible values as tan. X cannot equal pi over 2 plus n pi, where n is any real integer. So now that we have found our non-permissible values, we can simplify this. So let's do so using our quotient rules and our reciprocal functions. So tan angle, I'm going to put in terms of sine and cos. Secant angle, I'm going to put in terms of cos. So this is a quotient identity. This is a reciprocal identity. I'm going to utilize brackets. Since I'm dividing different fractions, I'm going to utilize my brackets. So I'm going to substitute tan angle in for sine angle over cos angle. So tan angle over secant angle. Well, tan angle here, I'm going to substitute in for, zoom in here, sine angle over cos angle. Now my secant angle, I'm going to substitute in for 1 over cos. And maybe I'll do that in red. So this will be now 1 over cos angle. The reason I'm utilizing these brackets is now I can determine what terms are dividing what. So remember, when you divide by a fraction, you can multiply by that reciprocal. So I can now rewrite this as sine angle over cos angle multiplying cos angle over 1. So I flip this multiplied by the reciprocal. And now you can start seeing here that we can cancel these guys out. And what we are going to get is a simple sine angle function. Now, is it absolutely true that tan angle over secant angle equals sine angle? So is this a true statement here? No. Okay, this is not an identity, at least for all terms. That's what a true identity is. A true identity is something where if you plug in an angle here, you are always going to get the same solutions. But recognize this has a different domain, okay? If we want to write this out saying, well, we can use tan angle over secant angle, if we see this, we can represent this as sine angle. Well, this is only true if x cannot equal pi over 2 plus pi n, where n is any integer. Okay, so this is not a true identity because they both do not have the same domains. This has no restrictions on x. This does have a restriction on x. Now, that's how to solve it using or simplify using quotient rules and reciprocal rules, or sorry, identities. Now let's think about what their graphs might look like. If we make our way over here, we have graphed in red tan x over secant x. Now recognize this looks really close to what a sine function looks like. A sine function is essentially going to look almost the exact same. Okay, a sine function, we have a max here of 1, negative 1. And if we draw or write our quadrantal angles, this is pi over 2, pi, 3 pi over 2, and let's go to 2 pi here. Okay, if we draw that, our sine function is going to follow, let's maybe do it in a different color. This type of graph and curvature. Okay, and it would also go that other way. So this is negative pi over 2, negative pi, negative 3 pi over 2, and negative 2 pi. Okay, and it would go something like this. This is a really rough drawing of our sine graph. Okay, but you can get the point. You should know what sine angle looks like at this point if you are looking at this video. Now recognize, if we graph this in our graphing calculator, we would not be shown these holes. Okay, recognize these holes are in the general solution, x cannot equal pi over 2 plus pi n, where n is any integer. Okay, so if you graph these two, if you graph this function and you graph sine angle, you might go, well, they're the exact same graph, so they must be an identity. But that's not quite true, because what you're going to notice is these have holes that we cannot see. Since I used a different type of technology that does show us the holes, but on a graphing calculator, these won't pop up. So you're going to say, well, they're the exact same graph, they should be the same, but they are not. And that's why it is really important to understand and know how to solve it using identities and find those non-permissible values so we can determine if in fact they are a true identity or only identities for certain values of x.